Hi everyone. And the product mix we talk about, the mainly the what is mean by product mix and what is the marketing mix. We find out that market mix is the collection of the product, price, place, and promotion. It's not all about the promotion mix. The marketing mix consists of about the elements of the firm's marketing that designed to meet the customer needs and wants. It's normally we call 4 P's that include the product, price, promotion, and place. So in the product development, we talk about there are certain steps. First of all, we have to design some product. When you're designing a product which needs the customer requirements, we have to find out these steps. For example, we've known this as a GADDC. Generate the ideas, generating a good idea, a marketable idea, which actually satisfy customer needs and wants, which means the demand. And then we have to analyze those ideas, because every idea actually, there's some ideas they have market value, some ideas they don't have. So we have to find out the marketable, the productive idea, a technical possibility of the idea, and the suitability of the idea with the current product portfolio and with the legal idea. There are ideas sometimes might be illegal. So for example, let's say you might have a wonderful business idea. Imagine, let's say exporting marijuana, but marijuana is actually illegal in most of the countries. So like that, so it's a business idea, but the thing is that you can't execute the business idea because of the, it's not legal. Therefore, you have to find out a legal business solution which actually satisfies business needs and wants. That's why generating idea is the first step. After that, you have to analyze those ideas, the technical possibility and the technical know-how. That's the analysis part. And then we are talking about then develop the idea. We have to develop the prototype. Prototype of the idea we have to develop. That's called the prototyping, the initial testing, frequent changes and modification you can do. So in that certain stage. So that's called normally, you can see before you make a building or something, you can see there are architectures are there. They actually make some prototype of the business. So these prototypes are normally they're given at the end. So normally people can identify, okay, this is the building that we're going to build. Like that, it's a prototype, the developing of the idea. That's called the prototype making, the development of the, development means like doing some experiment or making the sample, like test run. Before that, we are going to commercialization. Before we are making the we are going to make it like a international level. So or national level, we have to make some kind of a sample that is called the developer stage of the product, right? And then the last steps of the product, generally the product development process is a GADTC, the test marketing part. Test marketing part, after making the prototype, you have to do the small test run, like we call test marketing, and get the information about what consumers think in the first round. And then final stage is the commercialization and the launch, which means you are going to launch it to the worldwide, and like you are doing the commercially, like commercial production you are going to start. Okay, and after that, we talk about the goods and services. We talk about the difference between goods. Goods are tangible thing. There are consumer goods and industrial goods. And they talk about the services also. There are consumer services and industrial services. And talk about the packaging, the benefits of packaging. The benefits mean the protection providing, environmental friendly and cost effective, giving information from the label and the designing process and the convenience. We call that PACKAG packages. And in my previous session, we talked about the get a good introduction about the product life cycle. Product life cycle, there are certain possible questions and so many questions are there. It's a very exam pilot area, product life cycle, even the extension strategies. This time, even the recent one, also June 2021, the IGCSE paper, this kind of a question is there. They're asking the recent paper also, for a small business, what are the extension strategies in their marketing? So product life cycle, the last point we talk about DIGMSD, right? Development stage, the stage that you're doing the research and development in the labs, and the like prototype development, idea generation, that point, development stage, the initial stage with no sales. After that, introduction stage, like test marketing, and the, like we are starting in the beginning of the production, that's called introductory stage. And then growth stage means the popular, most popular, or most attractive product. And then mature stage means your sales become more peak level, maturity and saturation. A lot of competitors also enter into market and the market becomes saturated. And then last stage is the decline stage, where sales start decline because of the, there are more quality products or more rivalry or new products are they are approaching into the market, you have to decline. So like that, this is the product life cycle, how this moves. In the beginning, there is no sales at all. So it's flat curve, and you can see the after introduction stage, you are going to increase it a little bit. And then growth stage, the high steeper range is there. When it comes to maturity stage, you have the peak level, it's like a summit of the mountain. And then we're going to the decline stage, where sales starts drop suddenly. But we talk about the in this level, at the saturation point, the decline stage, we have some certain strategies to actually prolong the product life cycle without decline, because declining is like it's a bad thing for a product. They are going to divest on the market. But some products we have, we can make some new strategies to actually extend this product life cycle and become this product like a evergreen product. You can see this product, some products life cycles are different. Every product life cycle is not have this kind of a span. Some product life cycle span is very short. Short span of life cycle, you can see within like 2.5 years, it will actually come into the peak level and going down. For example, let's say a fashion, or let's say a song or something. We can see one song, sometimes less than 2.5 years. I don't think song can be in the peak level for 2.5 years. Or movie, very short life cycle. In the beginning, they have, for example, a Marvel movie. Imagine, let's say, Spider-Man or right, whatever. This Marvel movie, or let's say take about any kind of a movie, let's say the Kong versus Godzilla or whatever, is actually the peak level. After releasing the movie, that the popularity will be there about like 1 month, maximum 2 months. And after that, what happened? Then another movie comes out, then their product popularity will go down like that. So that's why some products are there, very short span of life cycle. Their development stage will take some time to make the film. For example, let's say 1 year. Or 6 months, and then the introductory stage, and they're going to introduce, and there's a grand premiere, and then they're going to peak level, and you got the recording, like a box office records you're going to make, and then after certain time, then your popularity will go down. Spectators will actually, everyone watch that movie, and then it will be available everywhere, and then your popularity will be going down. Some products are not like that. Some products actually take some time to develop. For example, let's say for 2 years, 3 years, it will take some time to develop. And then after that, it will become the peak level for certain years, and then it will be there forever, long time without declining. Like medicine, you can say, like vaccines you need after developing for a certain time. So people start using those vaccines. You can see now for the COVID-19, there are certain vaccinations are there. So now everything going to be there forever in the business, that business world, Pfizer, it can be the different, like now Oxford vaccine, and then Pfizer vaccine, CoShield vaccine, COVAX vaccine, Sputnik vaccine. So many vaccine companies are there. So they actually, after the research and development, they're introducing it to the market. Then World Health Organization giving the permission, and WHO gives the permission, then you can launch the product into the market. People start vaccination, and then you can see the product will be there forever, long time, without declining, right? So that's how some different products actually behaving. So that also keep in mind, some product life cycles are different. Okay, now we're going to talk about the extension strategies. It will be in detail, the strategies which actually prolong the product life cycle before it declines as a product, the extension strategies. This question was there this time, 2021 June paper. This question actually asked by EdExcel in 2021 paper. But they asked actually extension strategies. Was for a small business, their paper one actually, they recently, paper two also they had like yesterday, and then paper one, they actually recently they asked this question, what is extension strategy for a small business? You can see, if you have a product actually sales, imagine you're feeling the product sales going down, you can have the extension strategies like this. You can find a new market for a product. For example, like selling abroad. It's a good example. Or sometimes finding a new users for a product. For example, like a Ralph Lauren extend his product Polo brand, right? For clothes, from not only for the t-shirts, but into towels and bed sheets and everything, towel and bedding, everything. So they actually develop the product, extend the product portfolio and modify the product. Modification also possible thing, like Volkswagen has done this many times for a Golf GTI vehicle, which was launched after 1975. Certain times you can modify the product. You can say like Signal toothpaste is a product like that. So original product was there, but now they have modified the product, different tastes. I can see signal herbal, signal close up, like that. Different products they have modifying and they launch into the market. And develop a product range, for example, like a crispy manufacturer, bringing out new flavors. That's another thing. Product range you can develop. Like ice cream developer, you can see ice cream company, they can develop different product range like vanilla, like chocolate, strawberry, fruit and nut. Some different versions they can have. Like Baskin Robbins, you can see they have different flavors they have. Therefore, the ice cream market, you can see it never drops because new flavors always comes. Like a Lego also same thing, a new models, a new toys, a new models and techniques they are normally introducing. And changing the appearance of packaging. For example, like Coca-Cola, filling the Coca-Cola bottle, they actually change for a long time for certain things, the size of the cans, the glass bottle, the you can see plastic bottles and different size plastic bottles and different small 300 milliliter, 500 milliliter, 1 liter, 1.5 liter, 2 liter, like that, different, because of family pack, party pack, so different. They are selling in the cans. So this happens actually, change in the product packaging and encourage more frequent use of the product. That's another example, like persuading people to eat cornflakes for supper as well as for breakfast. Like that. So this kind of product portfolio questions, product lifecycle questions are there. So I'm going to show you one example right now. This is a possible question, which is actually on, you can see this is May actually 2021, recent possible question. They actually have given this time. So this possible question, small business paper. It's a case study called Ednoif. It's a farm growing like organic vegetables and fruits and everything of a accommodation for breakfast. And then set up by Amanda and then Ken Edwards in UK. So it's a farm, organic farm, right? So that's a case study, organic farm thing. So they're using recycling, everything. So look at this, this question. This corner, also you can find state one reason why no segment is target market by income. Target market, that market segment, we talk about that. They're finding out income as their target market. Why? One reason, because organic farming, little bit expensive thing. Their target market is the rich people. So like, and then they're asking this question. This is a question I want to focus today. Explain one strategy a small business might use to extend. Explain one strategy a small business might use to extend the product life cycle of one of its products. So this is not linked to the case study because it's explained question. So it's A1. So you can write some 1 point, one strategy a small business might use to extend product life cycle. So then they are going to decline. They can find this extension strategy to actually prolong their life cycle. So for a small business also. So when you're writing this one, so you can write one of this that we discussed right now, the extension strategies, including for a suitable one for a small business. Finding a new market, for example, selling abroad, I don't recommend for small business because selling abroad is very suitable for large business. Finding new users for a product, that can be possible because like not only t-shirts, that for example, like Ralph Lauren do like a polo brand, now into towels and bedding also like that. You can say finding new users for a product. Or encouraging more frequent use of product. Like say like encouraging more frequent use, for example, hand sanitizer market, you can see. Encouraging more frequent users. Those days people actually they use it very few times. Now they're always encouraging every 1 hour. If you can, you can actually wash your hands and use the hand sanitizer. So hand sanitizer market also is very, that's why they are encouraging more frequent use because of this mainly because of the pandemic situation. That's the one strategy small business also can do, encourage frequent use. Or change the appearance packaging also possible. Develop the product range also possible, right? Modifying the product also possible. But small business, I think the best thing I think you can say without selling abroad, you can see finding a new users and encouraging more frequent users. As a result of that, you can see more people will be able to actually you can attract. As a question asking, what is the strategy? One strategy they can use to extend the product life cycle. Explain. Give one reason, one strategy, and explain that thing with the example. You can memorize this example like Kellogg's, persuade their people to eat cornflakes for supper as well as breakfast like that. In explanation, you can use example out of the case study to explain their point, right? So after exercise strategy, you can see we are moving on to activity number two, case study Microsoft. You can see here Microsoft Windows, it's a well-known global brand. Microsoft computer, operating software to be found on a large number of computers around the world. First version introduced in 1985, called the Windows 1. So it had a color, 16-bit interface, and was less than 1 MB in size. Many of the basic programs using today's system, such as a Paint, Notepad, Clipboard, and Write, were present in Windows 1. The most recent version in Windows 10 launched in 2015. This version has two ways of operating, like one for the touch control tablets, and other one is the one for PCs and keyboard. You can see this table, launching dates and everything they have given. You can see Windows 1, 2, 3 from the bottom, 1985, 87, 90, 95, 95, Windows 98, 98, Windows 2000 in 2000, Windows ME, Windows XP, Windows Vista in 2006, Windows 7 in 2009, and Windows 8 in 2012, and Windows 10 in 2015. So like that, so you can find out those products and their launch periods and everything. So what they're asking in this question, they're asking two questions. What is meant by extension strategy? Use example from this case study for your explanation. Discuss benefits of Microsoft using extension strategies. You had at least two benefits of your NNA analysis. Right, you see what are the benefits of Microsoft, what is the extension strategy and all. You can see chapter 36, the activity number two answer. Here we go, Microsoft, you can see. What is meant by extension strategy? In this case study, they mentioned extension strategy are designed to lengthen the life of an existing product. They may be introduced before the product starts to seriously decline. If a product can be successfully refreshed, sales levels along with revenues may start to recover or even grow. In this case, Microsoft has extended the life of Microsoft Windows by continually updating the product. Since Windows 1 was introduced in 1985, and they have 11 major updates along with many other versions of the list shown in table 36.1. Each new version is improved technically and usually contains the new features. The product has now been on the market for 31 years. Yeah. So the benefits of extension strategy, you can see you can actually sell your product forever, evergreen product. You can actually get the answer. One of the main benefit extension strategies that product will continue to generate revenues and profit for a long period of time. Product is likely to be more profitable in the later stages of its life because the research and development costs will have been recovered. Consequently, provided the cost of the extension strategy is used not too high, the longer the life of a product, the more profit will be made. Although Microsoft might invest quite a large amount of money in research and development on the new versions in Windows, the benefit must be greater than the costs because there have been 11 new versions. Another benefit, look at second benefit with the application of lengthening the product life cycle of its product with effective extension strategies is that competitors will find it more difficult to enter into the market. So they can keep the monopoly level because of that. If a business is able to keep updating and modifying the product to make it even better and more appealing, the competitors know that they will have to bring out something really special to make an impact to the market. Each new version of Windows that Microsoft launches has a better technology and new features. This helps to retain customer loyalty and make it more difficult for other software producers to make take market share away from the Microsoft. So that happens normally. That's the main two advantages. So first, what's the first advantage? They will be able to continually generate revenue and profit, become more profitable, and like 31 years with the 11 update, they can stay forever. Like, you know, they can be always be like a consistency of the business will be assured. And second advantage is actually they're saying that they can maintain their market share and good competitive level, competitive advantage because of that. Other competitors will be scared, or they can't actually give a good fight with the Microsoft because of their continually modifying and updating their products. So there's a two advantage of product extension strategy, right? Now we'll move on to the new part of this chapter. The last part of this product mix is the product life cycle is over. Now Boston metrics. Like product portfolio analysis is one of the key, what you call the pinnacle of the product mix of the marketing lesson. So if you're a business, normally a lot of business organization nowadays, they are not actually surviving from one product. They have different product lines or different businesses. It's a group of company. You can see in the group, there are certain business lines are there. Sometimes one may be doing apparel industry. Sometimes they might do a transportation industry. Sometimes they might do a electronic industry. Sometimes they might do a hotel or like a traveling and tourism. So like different, or sometimes into the agriculture. So like that, so certain business organization, they actually have different business paths. Or even the, let's say, even in the one business line, they can have multiple products. Example, to take example of Apple, Apple company, they have different multiple products they're manufacturing. iPhone, and can say tablets, MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, the laptop versions, and then Apple, the iWatch versions are there. So like that, they're manufacturing different products through the Apple brand. So like that, in that kind of situation, we call this known this as a product portfolio. Because in the definition of product portfolio, a range of products a business is currently marketing. We call a range of product business is currently marketing, we call a product portfolio. So this model was introduced by Boston Consultancy Group in USA. Is still available at company Boston Consultants Group. Therefore, we know this one, we give some credit to the this metrics as a BCG metrics or Boston metrics. Simply, we call Boston metrics. You know, everyone knows Boston is a city in USA. So because of they are giving that credit Boston because of that firm, after doing a thorough research in, about the market, they actually came into conclusion that the product portfolio of a business is, looks like this. They dominate different symbols for their product portfolios, different products. So you can see it's a product portfolio, Boston metrics definition. It's a 2x2 metric. Right? That's why you can see four cages we can see in this matrix, four cages. This is like a so many times this was tested in the IGCAC and AS level also. Therefore, in the first shy, you can actually take this into absorb this knowledge into your mind. You can see it's a 2x2 metrics, describe the products according to the market share and the enjoy and whether the market has any potential for growth, market share and market growth. Some people, they call this growth share metrics also. Somehow, you can see this represent different symbols. We talk about the star. You can see the market share part here. Even actually market share can be go to the vertical as well as horizontal axis as well. Therefore, always don't think that this is always stable. Always star is in this corner and dog is in this corner. Right, question mark is in this corner, and then your top right hand corner is always cashed out. Don't think that's a myth. That's wrong, because it's always these variables can be changed in anywhere. Market growth can be go not only horizontal, can be switched to vertical axis, and even the high low thing you can, that also can switch, right? That also can switch high low also. Even high can be, I can write in the bottom, and low can be right in the top. Even you can see this case, high they wrote in the bottom side. And low they wrote in the other side, mathematically wrong. So this is not a mathematical model, that also keep in mind. It is just like a small matrix which actually gave the relationship in two variables, market share and market growth. So if both market share and market growth high, that means market share high means more popular product. Market growth high means like a very popular and very trendy product. High market share means much more demand is there. Both high we call star. Right, star products, like some, you know, every company, there are star products. For example, I can guess an Apple company, their star product is iPhones, right? So iPhones, star product, both high star. On the other hand, if both low, which means market growth also low, popularity low, and market, the customers also low, share also low, low we call dog products. A lot of students, they're asking, sir, why you are taking the symbol dog? So I first of all, I have said I'm not the one who taking the symbol. The Boston Consultants Group only introduced the symbol. They say, okay, dog product means something, you know, that's a bad product like dog. But, you know, as a, I'm also like a animal lover. So I don't want to make the use of the dog symbol, but what to do? The metrics, they introduce a dog product. Some people, sometimes they call it, don't be such a dog, something. Né? So dog means then bad product. So like market share also low, market growth also low, which means a dog product, which means yeah, popularity of the product also low, demand also low. Therefore, it's recommended to divest the product from the market. So I can get a good example from iPhone, Apple company. Again, if you remember, I don't know how many of you actually remember. They are using have a Apple Nano iPod. How many of you remember Nano iPod? They have used a long time ago for music. So a lot of people actually, they use a Walkman disc, and then after that iPod versions, they came like font size iPods, and then after that Nano iPod they use only for just to listen music. But later on, Apple realized people just don't want devices just to listen to music. So even mobile phone also you can do for that purpose, use for that purpose like that. So they stopped producing that version. Nano iPods are not there, even iPods also not there anymore. No one actually want to use the iPods anymore because they divest from the market. The other one is the cash cow. You can see if you have high market share, high demand, that is the product is like in the peak level of your metrics, product is in the peak level, we call that a cash cow. Like you have still a lot of demand is there for the product, and then, but the market growth is very low. Market growth is low. So that is called the cash cow product, because the popularity is still going down, but the still market share is there, like old product in the iPhone. For example, Apple company, you can see MacBook, MacBook, and also, Apple, this comes under cash cow. So cash cow products are normally have a high market share, but low market growth. There is no consistency in the market share because the cash cow products are always subject to the maturity level, always saturated. That's why it's still generating good income. Like MacBook Pro and MacBook Air and laptops, they are earning still money. People still buying those laptops, but the marketing strategy is use that money to develop the stars. That's why they call cash cow. Take the milk from the cow, and they call harvesting strategy. Take the milk and you can use it for the development of the other business. And finally, we're going to talk about the question mark. In some books, this one is introduced as a problem child or crying child. So question mark means the youngest product in your product portfolio in the business. For example, in the Apple company, you can see iWatch is the youngest product in the product portfolio. Or AirPods, young product. So still market popularity is low, demand is low, but high growth potential we can see. High growth potential in future, we can expect a lot of people might use that iWatches, they will use the iPods and all. They might use the AirPods and all, so they can find. So that's the youngest product in your product portfolio. You can categorize as a question. So look at these features, especially, right? So in the AirPod, yes. One student actually give an answer. AirPod are normally is another example that we are using. For example, like for Apple, this thing. So yeah, you can see now at the end, you can see this is like a similar to the product life cycle. The beginning product, the young product is called question marks, and the product which is in the growth stage, you can see the star product. Product in the maturity stage, we call the cash cow product, and products in the decline stage, we call the dog product. So it's like that. So those are the features of the products. Boston metrics, look at this thing. Stars are valuable products for the business. They have a high market share, but also have a potential to grow, and they like to be profitable. And cash cows are mature products, and they have a high market share, but the market is not likely to grow very much. And cash cow generate a steady flow of income for the business. And question marks are the products with a low market share, but the market is growing. If the right marketing action is taken, these products could be do well. They have to be, but that's why you have to make a right marketing action. You have to do this can future, this can be the star products. And dog products are normally we call the end of their product life cycle. So they have low market share and the market is not likely to grow anymore. So dogs are likely to be placed with new products, dog products. So what are the strategies that we are using here? Investment strategy, harvesting strategy, and divesting strategy. Okay, so that's the end of the product life cycle and this lesson. We'll move on to this MCQ and we'll after that we'll wind up our today's session with that. You can see the product life cycle is done with that. Look at the small and large business, also really important, because you can see now the recent paper small business, this question was their extension strategy related. The marketing mix is important for all businesses regardless of their size. If the business ignores certain elements of the marketing mix, they may not perform as effectively as their competitors. However, some aspects of the marketing mix may be more important to large firms. For example, large businesses are more likely to invest heavily in the product development. Yes, of course. And like iPhone and everything. And also, this is because they have more resources, more money. Also, if a large business discovers a brand new product or material, the reward for investment in product development can be huge. Okay, look at the MCQs, guys. You can use the chat line to communicate. You can give the answer through there. The first stage in the product life cycle called. First stage in the product life cycle is called. Here I can see a couple of answers pop up. The answer is given. Lot of students give the correct answer. First stage of the product life cycle is called the development stage. DIGMSD. So it's the development stage, the first stage. Development, introduction, growth, then only saturation. Okay, question number two. Okay, students are answering these questions. Very good. Energy we can see in the class, right? In the Boston Metrics, a product with low market share but high potential for growth is called. Yes, students are correct. Give the correct answer. Very good. That's answer is C. Question mark. Very good. Let us give the correct answers. Keep it up. So potential to growth, high potential of growth, but low market share is called question mark. Question number three, also student, very good. Like a lot of students, all of them actually get the correct answers. Which of the following is an example of a service sold to a business? Following is an example of a service sold to a business. Different answers are coming. So answer for this one, B, office cleaning. Yeah, that's a service. Smartphone is a product, machine is a product, fuel or for lorries is a product. So good actually. So only service is actually the office cleaning services. Okay, the last question, which of the following is an element of a marketing mix? Element of a marketing mix. Profit, cash, price, money. Okay, answers are coming. Yeah, okay. Three students gave the correct answer, very good. Correct answer is excellent. Four students, price. Price is the correct answer. Product, price, place, and promotion. Yeah. So today, normally we talk about the product, price, place, promotion, the Boston metrics we talk about, and product life cycle we talk about. One past paper question we discussed at the MCQ. In the Boston metrics, keep in mind, again, I'm revising. This is a product portfolio. If you have a product portfolio in a business organization, you can use this Boston metrics. So this can be switched different places. In MCQ questions, also this question are there. They ask actually on the MCQs also. This question, they are given A, B, C, D. Sometimes they ask you, what is A? Sometimes they're giving, okay, this is star, cash flow, question mark, or what is this axis called, right? So in our discussions, in our revision program, we're going to discuss that one. We'll see you again on my next session. So I can discuss more past paper question, including chapter review questions we can talk about. This here, we have a chapter review question. I would like to give this question as a homework question for you. So if you are doing this question, you can email me the answer. You can use my Google Classroom to upload your answers. Or WhatsApp me. A chapter review question called Cheesy Snacks question. Read this question, case study, and they have given nice data, details, everything given, and they have given 8 questions. What is meant by the term marketing mix? You can answer that question. What are the features of a cash flow? Cash cow of the Boston metrics, cash cow features, huh? High market share, low market growth. What is the question number cheesy puff in the Boston Matrix? Read the case study and find me the answer. Discuss how cheesy snacks might be used in the Boston Matrix in management of product portfolio. I would like to change this commandment as analyze. Analyze how this use of the Boston Matrix. Two advantages I'm expecting. And describe the main features of the product life cycle of cheesy. Like I see, analyze question. This also can be a 6 marker. And last question, the sixth question, assess whether cheesy nut should be replaced with blue cheesy crackers. Make a clear judgment in your evaluation. So I would like to give this question as a 12-marker question. So mainly in this 12-mark, you know, the structure, definition, two advantages, two disadvantages, and the conclusion. So it's a good, this could be, after your question, will be a very good practice question for all of you. So please do this question as a homework. Or if you are a viewer, you just go through this case study. You can actually get a good idea and you can try to figure it out, the answers and everything. The cheesy snack case study in the textbook. Right, that's textbook page number 306 in the textbook page. 306, 307. Read the case study and ask this 6 question. Right, so you can answer and you can, before the next session, you can send me the answers. Okay, so that's the overall thing. So so next session will be the pricing session. So we end the product portfolio, the product Boston Matrix, product lifecycle, extension strategies, really good productive lesson. First session, actually, I go through mainly on the packaging, the product portfolio, marketing mix, and imports of packaging and goods and services, everything. So today, we talk about, again, I revising the product development stages, packaging, product lifecycle, DIG, MSD, and go to the Microsoft case study, and we talk about the Boston Matrix finally at the end of the lesson. So yeah, so that's it for the lesson. Thank you very much for participating. See you in my next session, guys. Have a nice day. Thank you. Bye.